You have her number, don't you?
Someone, I don't call her very often.
Have you talked to her since these proceedings, Sonia?
Yes, she's called me a couple of times.
You talked to her about the testimony in these proceedings, did you?
No.
You never talked to her about what?
About the testimony in these proceedings, the testimony today?
No, not today. We started on Monday.
Yes.
You talked to her since Monday, correct?
I don't remember. I might have, but I can't say for sure.
You can recall whether or not you talked to someone about these proceedings and were on Saturday, and the hearing was on, the previous hearing was on Monday. You don't recall talking to her about that?
I don't. I said I may have, but I'm.
Would it surprise you that she indicated that you all talked?
No.
Is it some reason you would want this board to know that you spoke to Arbetta?
Absolutely not.
All right. You don't have a problem with your memory, do you?
No. No more than, I don't remember everything, but I remember all of it.
You indicated that you're certified through IAMC?
IIMC.
IIMC. And when did you receive that certification?
1997.
And what does that, that certification, explain to us what that is?
It indicates a certain number of hours of training and experience in combination. And it usually takes 4 or 5 years, 4 years to get the certification. And then for a while it had to be renewed, but it no longer has to be.
So it's not a certification that you're some type of expert in third-class city, correct?
I don't know how to answer that.
Are you an expert in third-class city?
I know some things.
Okay, but has.
I don't know what your definition of expert is.
Well, let me ask you this. When we're talking about the certification, all right, during your direct examination, you told this body that you were certified through the IIMC.
And the Missouri City Courts and Finance Office.
And what I'm trying to understand is a part of that certification, a certification that you're an expert in third-class cities?
No.
Okay. You're not an expert, are you?
I don't know what your definition of an expert is. I have a lot of training.
All right.
I don't know.
Let me ask you this. Has any entity other than yourself certified you as an expert in third-class city?
I don't know of such a certification, so no.
All right. So.
I don't believe.
All right, and you're not an attorney.
No.
You read the law just like any other layperson reads the law.
Yes.
And your experience might, your understanding might be better or worse than a regular layperson. Would you agree?
Yes.
And as the city clerk, your primary responsibility is to be the keeper of the minutes, correct?
That's one of my primary responsibilities.
Prepare the agenda.
Yes.
Prepare the minutes. Record the minutes. It's a ministerial type of position. Would you agree?
Not necessarily.
What do you mean?
Well, what do you mean by ministerial?
Ministerial means that you don't have discretion. You don't make policy, do you?
I don't make policy for the city council.
Who do you make policy for?
People in my department.
Okay. Because you're the head of the department?
Yes.
Now, who's the head of the city?
The mayor and city council.
The mayor and the city council. And who's responsible for taking care of the day-to-day operation?
The mayor has superintending control of the officers and affairs of the city according to the statute.
Okay, and who?
And the mayor and city council have the care, control, and management of the city according to the statute.
And do you understand that the council has to work as a collective, but the mayor can act alone?
In some cases.
Does the council have the authority to give direction to staff?
No.
All right, and in fact, your former mayor kind of clarified that in a memo. You remember that?
I do.
And what did he say?
He said that individual council members should not be coming in and telling staff members, go do this, go do that, go do that.
Because who has that authority?
The mayor.
The mayor has that authority,
or
correct?
Or the department head.
Or the department head. But who's over the department head?
The mayor.
And the mayor is an executive, correct? correct?
I suppose.
Do you understand the three branches of government?
Yes.
All right, we have an executive branch, correct?
Mm-hmm.
A legislative branch?
Yes.
And a judicial branch?
That's right.
And the city of Jennings have those three branches as well, correct? You have a court?
Yes.
All right, you have a mayor, correct? Is anyone else in that executive branch or the head of that executive branch other than the mayor?
No.
And then you have the council who makes the law, correct?
Law and policy approves things. They don't just make the law.
What else do they do?
They approve policies, they approve bills, they approve. They hire people, the mayor can't hire without their approval.
Okay, we'll talk about that. All right, let's go through the exhibits and there's quite a few. It'll be a while. Let's talk about exhibit one. Have you votes? That's a lawsuit that the mayor filed, correct?
Correct.
And she's the plaintiff and she named herself as the defendant and several, all the people and some department heads, correct?
All of the councilpeople and all of the department.
Okay. And it's an action for a declaratory judgment, correct?
Yes.
And do you understand that an action for declaratory judgment is an action that seeks the courts or asking the court to clarify individual legal rights or clarify whether or not something is legal or illegal? Is that your understanding?
I'm going to object to the characterization. The petition is for declaratory judgment as to legality or constitutionality of ordinances. There isn't any clarification involved. It has to do with the legality of these ordinances. So
I guess that I don't know if that's an objection or an argument. I have a question of the witness and I asked it. I'd like her to answer.
Objection's overruled.
Could you ask a question?
Sure, sure. Do you have an understanding of what a declaratory judgment action is?
Somewhat.
Okay, what's your understanding?
That it's asking for clarification, basically.
It's asking for clarification of an existing law because there's some confusion as it relates to that law, correct?
That's correct.
All right, and that's what the mayor was doing in her lawsuit that's identified as exhibit one, correct?
I assume that's what she meant.
Well, that was your understanding, correct?
Yes.
Did you talk to legal counsel about this litigation?
Yes.
And so they gave you clarity as to what it meant, correct?
Yes.
And you, according to your direct examination, never answered this lawsuit, correct?
That's correct.
And you heard representations made by Mr. Hessel. He was the attorney for the city, correct?
He was voted to be the attorney for the city, but the mayor never signed the contract.
That wasn't the question. He was the one that was engaged by the council as the attorney for the city in the act.
The council ordered the mayor to sign a contract to engage Mr. Hessel, but she did not sign.
All right. Was Mr. Hessel ever contacted?
Not by me.
Okay. Do you know whether he was ever contacted?
I don't know.
Who would have done that? Who would have made contact?